Millions of Australians are in line for an extra $1,000 in cash as early as next week after the Morrison government gained enough crossbench support to pass its tax cut plan in the Senate. We'll go live to Canberra and our political reporter Fiona Whelan. Fee, good morning. Those patient negotiations have paid off.
That's right, Davina. Deals have been done. And as a result, three more crossbenchers have agreed to support these tax cuts in full, which means they will pass through the Senate later today, provided nobody changes their mind at the last minute, of course. Now, if all goes according to plan from next week, some Australians will receive an extra $1,080 back in their tax refund. Overnight, Tasmanian Senator Jackie Lambie promised to vote in favour of the full package, but in exchange, she's asked the government to do something about Tasmania's housing issues. She wants it to pay off the state's public housing debt. The coalition has agreed to look at the situation. And while Senator Lambie has agreed to support the plan, she said she still has problems with the final stage to give tax relief to high-income earners from 2024.
I still have concerns about stage three, there's no doubt about that. Look, that's 5 or 6 years away, we've got another election. I can tell you now, if they were brought forward right now and we were doing it, this probably would not be the same decision.
We think it's important that we don't saddle the budget with a $95 billion tax cut in 5 years' time when the government can't tell us what services and programs that they will cut to pay for it.
Now, two Centre Alliance senators have also agreed to come to the table and support the plan in full. The government says it'll look into their concerns over the gas market and its impact on energy prices. Let's hear a bit from the Finance Minister.
We are always prepared to discuss with non-government senators issues, policy issues of concern to them and their constituents. And we're always prepared to consider issues they raise with us and make judgments as appropriate.
Now, as far as these deals go, nothing is set in stone. But as Senator Lambie pointed out, it all comes down to goodwill, saying it wouldn't be wise for the government to renege.